Hi, everybody. Reese Davis with you, bringing you the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 pregame show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Both of these teams among the best passing offenses in the country. Both ranked nationally in the passing game. There are weapons all over the field. But if anything, the secondaries ought to be used to it. I mean, they see a lot of this every day in practice. That's going to do it for us here on the pregame show. NCAA Football 14 action coming at you right now. Brad Nessler and Kirk Herbstreit. See how this game plays out as they get ready for the opening kickoff. And he got all of this one. Great kick. He's to the 20. Tackled at the 19. The quarterback brings his troops out onto the field for the first drive of the game. He tackles him for a loss.
Well, these days, you've got safeties playing up close to the line of scrimmage, almost like a fourth linebacker. The only way that you can keep them from cheating up is to take some chances downfield.
It's second and 12. Ball on the 17. Fires quickly to the tight end. The pass good for maybe 7 yards.
Decision here. Nice dump off. It's only 7 yards, but the offense will take that play every time.
Sends it out quick. Intercepted. And that's his 7th pick of the season.
For all you quarterbacks out there who haven't played this team yet, here's a tip for you. Don't throw the ball towards this guy.
First and 10. Ball on the 33-yard line. Now he's scrambling. And he's tackled at the 24-yard line. Carroll's the kind of kid that just continues to impress us, Herbie. I mean, he's taking his game to the next level, and his stats are making everyone in the country take notice. Carries the ball for a nice game.
Some guys are dangerous no matter where they are on the field. Whether they have speed, elusiveness, great vision, whatever the case may be, you have to find ways to get the ball in their hands.
Tackle for a loss.
You can't teach instinct. The ability to know where a play is going is something this safety has. That was a terrific effort.
From the 20-yard line, second down. They go with a run. Tackle made around the 12. And the linebacker comes up and makes a big stop.
This is textbook. This is how you're supposed to play against the run.
Play. He just blew past the blockers and dragged the quarterback out.
Boy, excellent play by the defense here. A few extra seconds and those receivers might have been open.
The sack makes this a fourth and very long. Got it. They tried to throw it. Sack.
sure about that.
Play call as they fail on fourth down. The quarterback comes back on the field, and I'm sure he's hoping to make up for that interception on the last drive.
And I don't think this defense will lay down lightly. They're going to try to continue to rattle this guy.
That's a great tackle.
That's the 32. Forward to about the 33.
That's a good gain of 1 yard. That'll make it 35.
And that one's going to hit the ground incomplete. They're going to be forced to punt it away.
It's a good hold by the defense on third down. Now their punt returner will get a chance to make something happen.
Smith awaits the snap. Room around the corner. Morris takes it at the 32.
He's at midfield. He makes it out to midfield.
The Owls really took care of business on defense that first time out, Kirby.
One of the great traditions of college football is this defense and the way they play with such passion and enthusiasm in this environment. We're seeing that again today.
This is a fun game. And I think we're going to see a lot of interesting football before it's over.
He's at the 40. Gains his way to the 33-yard line.
So he keeps it, and he gets a big first down.
The quarterback made a very good decision here not to pitch. He saw a break in the defense and just hit it for a big game.
He makes it out to maybe the 33-yard line.
That makes it 2nd and 10.
To the 23.
Sets up a screen. Tailback's got it. And he shoved out of bounds at the 23.
This was a great call from here. It looked like the defense was fooled and reacted a little bit late to the screen.
The offense needs something new down here in the red zone.
Looks for his running back.
They'll line it up again on third down.
Tailback, but he can't bring it in.
This to try to put his team up by a field goal.
He gets it up,
and the field goal is good. Reese Davis joins us in the studio with this update. Reese?
The Nittany Lions were ranked 18th. After that face plant, they'll be lucky to be ranked at all next week. And for Ohio State, they've now won 3 in a row. The Buckeyes take it by 3.
All right, thanks, Reese. Back to the live action here.
Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He's to the 20. And he makes it out to about the 24-yard line.
Well, Curtis, if you don't let the other team score, you're going to win. You can't lose. That's what's going on so far.
Well, this defense is bending a bit, but they're not breaking. They're off to a great start, keeping their offense and this team in a position to be able to win this game. Let's see if they can maintain it.
And while they are behind, they know they can knot things up in a heartbeat. It's way too early to change your game plan.
The defender has hands on it, but it
It's incomplete.
The defensive coordinator did a great job with the play call there. Put his defense in alignment and in position to be able to make a play on the football. Everything worked perfectly. They just dropped the football. Boy, the offense caught a break there.
Oklahoma!
Snags it complete out of bounds, though, and they're going to lose yardage.
Loss of three on the play. That'll make it third and 13.
It's third down and 13 to go. Ball on their own 21. He lets it go. And he snags that one. Right around the 46-yard line.
This guy is so versatile. You can use him at the line as an extra blocker or send him downfield like another wide receiver. Either way, he's a great resource on every down.
Nice run, and he's run that. He's going to aim this one to the sideline, trying to kick it out of bounds. He makes it out to maybe the 29-yard line. Got to give some applause to the defense. They really came out playing strong.
Well, you know better than me, Brad. This college football game is about emotion. And to be able to play great defense in a college game, you've got to come out and play with your hair on fire. We've seen that from both of these defenses so far.
A good job on their last drive, getting three. Let's see if they can get some more on this drive. Now he tries to buy some time. And he dives forward. Second and 12 coming up here. All on their own 38. And he's hit immediately. Throws it deep.
Jackson's intended to see a lot of the play. That makes it still hit the ball.
Locked to punt. I've got to think the offensive coordinator is not really that concerned right now.
Well, they're off to a slow start, but this is also part of just kind of getting an awareness and an understanding of what the defense is trying to do to your offense. Now you've got to make the adjustments, and then you go back and start calling plays if you think we'll be able to attack this defense and get points on the board.
He has some room. Nice one there. Taken down in the backfield.
You know, a lot of times coaches look to linebackers for leadership on defense. And on that tackle, he showed you why that's the case.
From their own 41-yard line, third down. And he's taken down at the 46. Back. the 45.
An exciting first quarter comes to an end.
3-0.
Welcome back here. We resume action now here in the second quarter.
So it's complete, but they didn't get much there.
And that's because the defense was just waiting on it, and they attacked. The quarterback should have found somebody else downfield.
He's pushed out of bounds. The 39-yard line. And it's the offense that takes the field on fourth down. Quick strike and he drops it. And the defense comes through.
In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions.
And they get nice yardage on that run.
That'll make it second and four.
Strike to his receiver, no good.
That makes it second and ten.
It's second and ten.
Ball on the 49. The quarterback in the gun. Empty backfield. Five wide receivers in a formation.
Pulls down the catch and he's got room here.
He's taken down at about the 37-yard line.
That makes it first and ten.
Stop
around the 31-yard line.
Call it a gain of 6 yards. That'll make it second and four.
He gets rid of this one.
Great job by the defense at getting after that quarterback. And right now, I think they've got him with some happy feet. He seems to be a bit rattled.
They're about 4 yards away here on third down. The 12-yard line.
First down.
Here's the halfback. And he's leveled at the 13-yard line. Nowhere to go for the halfback. That's a loss of one.
What a play, and that is first and goal.
That's a gain of 12 on the play. That makes it first and goal.
Second and goal.
get him in the backfield.
The D-line did a good job of nullifying out the blocks up front, and that allowed the linebacker to roam free and make the tackle on the backfield.
And this is the 12th play of the drive.
The Owls lose one of their key players with that injury earlier. Still in the locker room. We don't know the severity, but unlikely that he'll play any more football this afternoon.
And they'll bring him down behind the line.
It looked to me like he should have made the pitch, but he kept it instead and wound up going backwards.
Fourth down. This one should be makeable.
And he's got it.
Even though they gave up a field goal here, that defense is feeling pretty good about themselves right now. It could have just as easily been a touchdown.
Lodge ready to kick. Jones from the six. He's taken down at the 22.
Can this defense play any better? I mean, these guys have a great tradition. They live up to the billing today. Now we're starting to see whether or not this team can get it done. And if they are, then I think the defense should go down the offensive side of the field, talk to their own offense, and try to get them fired up to go out there and get some more points on the board.
And he's tackled at the 24-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 2 yards. That'll make it 7-7.
He makes his way out to about the 35. Tackle made around the 37-yard line.
Gain of 2 on the play. That makes it 2nd and 8.
Scrambling. And he hits him hard at the 41-yard line.
That's a gain of 4 on the play. That makes it 3rd and 3.
He's on the run. Diving for extra yardage.
Excellent route, and he did a great job of holding on to the football.
From the 41-yard line, first down. Tries to get around the corner. Gains his way to the 30-yard line. Scramble. Tackle at the 25-yard line.
That brings him 16-5.
Looking right. Intercepted.
He seemed a little hesitant on that throw. And that left the defender time to break on the ball and pick it off.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on their own 25. Fires up to his receiver. And a nice pickup there.
I'll tell you what, the defense gambled a bit here and came with the blitz. And the quarterback showed tremendous poise by making a good read and delivered a nice ball to the open man.
Let's go, let's go.
Taken down at the 44-yard line.
Total gain of 15 yards. That makes it first and 10.
I'm not sure the quarterback saw him when he was getting ready to pass because he stuck his ball right in the passing lane.
From the 44-yard line, second down. Wyatt gets the call. The defense didn't stop the pass, but they stopped him short of the sticks.
And that's the important thing here. Allow him to make the catch, but make sure you tackle him before he gets to the first down marker.
Fourth down, and the offense is still on the field.
And slam the door on him. That's the definition of coming through when it matters most.
They threw a pick the last time out. Should be interesting to see what they do this time.
The first rule on offense is to take care of the football. These guys need to remember that on this drive.
He's got nowhere to go. They didn't have much of a chance on that play.
Boy, this defense has a lot of speed. They're all over him by the time he caught the ball.
From their own 39-yard line, second down. Throw out to the receiver. He's hit and taken down. The Owls call a timeout. That's their second of the half.
Comes to a close.
6-0.
We played 30 minutes. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 halftime show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. David Pollack and I here in the studio to break down everything that just happened in your game. The Owls are behind at the break, but this thing has been really tight throughout. It's lived up to all of the billing up to this point. What do you expect to see coming down the stretch of these two great teams in the second half?
It's so cool to see a game that does live up to the billing, Race. We see so many games that are blowouts quickly, and this is a game that's going to be back and forth. It's going to be down the stretch, and who can make plays, who doesn't fold underneath the pressure, who doesn't make mistakes. So far in the second half, you don't have to worry about being down one possession. You know exactly what this was coming in. It's going to come down to the fourth quarter and who makes those big plays in those big spots.
We've done what we can do here at halftime. Time to get you back out to the second half. We'll keep an eye on everything going on in college football. Brad Nessler and Kirk Herbstreit ready with a call.
All right, Reese and David, thanks, guys. Second half action just about ready to start here. Morris from the 8. Gets to about the 27-yard line.
You know, this offense is doing a pretty good job moving the football. The problem is they're not coming up with touchdowns. The offensive coordinator who's been up here next to us, Brad, the booth next to us, he's actually just taken off his headsets, and I think he's going down to the field to be next to the quarterback and the rest of this offense to try to engage with them to realize how important it is to finish these drives.
And he's hit before he can go anywhere.
Quick strike to the receiver. That play was going nowhere.
You give a lot of credit to the defense here, recognizing pass and swarming to the receiver.
Brought down after a nice run up the middle.
That's good for the yards. That'll bring up 36.
Play fake, looking to run. He's to the 40. Quick out to his receiver. And down he goes at the 49.
Makes it second and six.
Let's go, let's go.
Makes it to the 41.
That's a deep 10 play. First down.
Carries him off for a nice gain. About 5 yards on the quarterback keeper.
That brings him second and five.
From the 36-yard line, it's second down. And he's hit immediately.
Number 53 makes the tackle at the 28-yard line. That makes it first and 10.
To fit it in there, and it'll be intercepted.
This quarterback better start making better decisions in the passing game. Otherwise, this corner will come up with even more picks in the future.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on their own 28. Able to hit his receiver. He overthrew it.
Yeah, and that's a throw he should make every single time.
Here comes the pressure. Quick throw, incomplete. One of his receivers. We've got third and 10. Ball on the 28-yard line. Fires that put him into the tailback. And he is drilled at the 30-yard line.
Mullins on the tackle at the 30-yard line. Fourth down.
Schmidt awaits the snap. Breaking that tackle. What a hit. Nice yardage on the run back. You know the offense will be looking to do better this time out.
And we'll see how aggressive this defense is when they come back out. I wouldn't be surprised if they kept up the pressure and try to fluster this quarterback some more.
And they got to him before he could get back to the line. From their own 45-yard line. Second down. Six-yard line.
That makes it
the punter. He's out for the 30, and he makes it out to about the 34-yard line. There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing. Nice run up the middle. And he makes it out to about the 41-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 1 yard. That makes it 3rd and 3.
He's at midfield, and they make the stop right around the 46-yard line.
And made it to the sticks for the first down.
Caught, open field. He's taken down at the 46. It's second down now. They're just a few feet away from that first down marker. To about the 18-yard line.
Gain 3 yards. That'll make it 7-7.
Looks like he flinched down there on the line.
False start. Offense.
That penalty will move him back a bit.
Yeah, with so many young guys out there, it's bound to happen occasionally.
From the 23-yard line, it's second down. Again, he'll get the call. They'll bring him down
at about the 25-yard line.
So it's also 2 yards on the play. That brings up 3rd and 14.
This is the 10th play of this drive. And it's the offense that takes the field on 4th down. Got a man, watch out here. Big play there, and now they're looking at 1st and goal.
Field, he'll try to put his team up by a point.
And he adds the extra point. Let's throw it out to Reese now for a studio update.
The Cardinals bring their top 20 ranking into today's game. Back and forth these two teams go, neither one giving an inch. We could be headed to a photo finish. The Cardinal lead 28-21.
All right, thanks, Reese. Back to the live action here.
Everyone's all lined up and ready for kickoff.
He makes it out to maybe the 30-yard line.
This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense.
Pass right, running back's got it.
Tackle made at the 41-yard line.
Call it a gain of 11 yards. First down.
Fires it out. And he's tackled right around the 42-yard line. Look at his scramble out. He can't get away from the pressure. From the 47-yard line, second down.
Up the middle for a nice game.
There's a strike complete, and he hits him hard at the 41.
He doesn't want a touchback here. He wants to knock this ball inside the 10.
It's a short kick.
Six points and a pretty display of passing was a result of their last drive.
Kirk, do you expect the defense to take a different approach here?
When this quarterback is on, he is on.
It already seems like whatever this defense is trying just isn't working. Maybe if they add just a little bit more pressure, they might be able to force him into a mistake.
Through three quarters now, and still the defenses are shining. The Owls lead 7-6.
Welcome back to the action. Fourth quarter. This one will decide it. Tight ball game through three.
Third down, 5 yards to go.
All on the 37-yard line.
And he's taken down around the 42-yard line.
That makes it fourth and inches.
Morris is the deep man awaiting the return.
Almost with a fair catch. We really thought we were going to see a different offense out there.
I thought we'd see more points. I thought we'd see better execution. And right now they're losing this game because the offense just didn't show up.
Things aren't tied, but they might as well be. It's this drive that could really dictate the tone for the last quarter. takes it out to his receiver in a hurry. And he's shoved out of bounds right around the 24-yard line.
Pick up this third and long here in the fourth quarter.
Delivers to the halfback on the screen. Tackles around the 22-yard line. Jones is back deep to return. He's tackled at the 49-yard line. Made a few guys miss on his way to a quality return. Both teams realize that when the ball is snapped, we're one play away from a very different ballgame. Picks up five with the carry. Brought down right around the 44-yard line.
That's exactly how they drew it up in the sideline, and now they get the ball back.
That'll bring up fourth and five.
Right now he wants to get this kick away and change field position.
Didn't get all of that one.
That turned out to be a nice little bunt there.
It was just a little pooch kick, but it was very effective.
You know this is a real crucial time in the game. It could still go either way.
Gets hit like that, you'd be surprised to see the old coach get on his lineman to protect the quarterback a little bit better.
So the sack makes this a second and long. He goes out of bounds.
Around the 26-yard line.
Nice pickup as they connect on the pass play.
But they look to be in sync right now. They're both reading the defense properly, and the result is a nice game.
He's scrambling. So he got enough for the first down there.
Yep, nice call to run the ball there on third down. I like it.
He's going to try and scramble.
And they make the stop.
Around the 41-yard line.
He makes his way to about the 48.
First down.
This is the eighth play of this drive. Just under 3 to go in regulation. Strike to his receiver. No good.
It's third down. They're about 2 yards shy of the sticks.
Goes quick to the receiver. Falls incomplete.
Taylor was intended to see him. That'll make it 4th and 2.
Out of rhythm in this one right now. The defenses have had a lot to do with that, obviously. They're given different looks. They're blanketing the receivers. They're slowing down the running game. Both teams realize that when the ball is snapped, we're one play away from a very different ball game.
Set. Blue 19.
Gets rid of it quickly.
Picked off. It's the quarterback. He's tackled around the 44-yard line.
And for Sampson, it seems like he's been listening to the opponent's huddle all year long.
And it could lead to a new school record.
It's fun to watch this guy read the quarterback's eyes. He knows their routes as well as they do, and that's why he makes all these plays.
First and 10, ball on the 44.
Screen pass. He's got his halfback.
Here's an opening. And he tackles him hard. That's a 39.
Gain of 17 yards. First down.
A little more than 2 minutes to go in the fourth quarter. Here's the halfback on the screen.
Now bring him down.
Around the 31-yard line.
Gain 8 on the play. That makes it 2nd and 2.
Scrambling. He's at the 20.
Tackle made at the 19-yard line.
Gain of 12 on the play. That makes it 1st and 10.
They try to get a head start there.
False start. Offense.
Maybe he got the cadence wrong coming out of the huddle. The coaches have a low threshold for mistakes like that.
1st and 15 now after the penalty.
Inside the 10.
What a play to
set him up with a 1st and goal.
That's good for the 16 yards. That makes it 1st and goal.
Scramble. And he's sacked.
Absolutely perfect call by the defensive coordinator. He brought just the right amount of pressure from the right direction, and it seemed to confuse the offense.
From the 11-yard line, it's 2nd down. Tackled at the 4.
Howard gained 7 yards with a catch there.
The Owls will use their 1st time out of the half.
And this play is number 8 on the drive.
14.
A little over 9 in the game.
Touchdown! And they take the lead.
Late in the 4th quarter now. With that score, this game's a one-possession ball game, and it's really going to get tense from here on out. So the offense is going to go for 2.
And they will get the 2.
Lockett looks ready to kick this one off. Jones from the four. Tackle made at the 22.
Cover the clock, Herbie, and there's not a lot of time to make something happen here.
It's been ugly for both of these offenses. You got to think about maybe spreading out the defense, giving your quarterback a chance to either run or throw. Somebody's got to make a play here to determine the outcome of the game.
I'm sure the quarterback would love to make amends for that last pick.
The first rule on offense is to take care of the football. These guys need to remember that on this drive.
The Owls call a timeout. That's their second and a half. Defense looking for another sack in the second down and long situation. This one out to the left.
Pulls it in. First down, and he's knocked out of bounds. We have less than a minute to go.
He's in trouble. And he can't get away from the pressure.
Call the loss of 6 yards on the play.
Check, check. Eight, Bruin.
Or three. Spikes the ball.
That makes it 3rd and 15.
Third down and long, and they could really use a big play by their quarterback here this late in the game.
Got it.
Well, a lot of frustration by that offense, but you've got to give the defense credit for coming up with a stop in this quarter in a game this close.
Let's it go.
So the play of the day, fourth and ball game, and the defense comes up with the stop of the day and what will be the win. Game and poise is what it's all about here. Who's going to have it and who won't? We should just see the quarterback right here winding down the rest of the squad. The Owls are going to have to call their third and final timeout. You're an offensive coordinator. You love this play. His quarterback will take a knee.